No, I actually never saw myself in a role of speaking openly and being any kind of role model when it came to LGBT topics. I mean, my takeaway after college sports was like, don't ever talk about this, because in a lot of the corners of women's sports, that is the MO. Do whatever you want in your small little group, but like, we're not talking about, you know, identity in any way. And so that's how I lived for so long, that if you had told me in 2005, like the year after I graduated from CU, that like 10 years from now I would like speak openly about sexuality, like that would have been the furthest thing from what I envisioned of my future. I always wanted to write, and I wanted to write books. But I really, really loved the idea of like putting something tangible and lasting into the universe. But I came to, like, along the way, I came to realize that for probably for most of us, like the most difficult, painful parts of who we are and our identity or our experiences usually end up being the thing that most connects us to other human beings. And so I realized I couldn't run away from it anymore, because I needed to figure out who I was and what my voice was, and it was going to be impossible to develop my voice and how I looked at the world without actually being open about like a huge part of who I am. My name is Kate Fagan, and I am CU.